How to set up IVR in Issabel. First, log into Issabel. Then go to the PBX menu and under the PBX configuration submenu. In the IVR section, three parts are required: IVR, announcement, and system recording. Enter the system recording section and upload the recorded file according to Issabel's declared format, WAV PCM 16 bits 8000 MHz, through the upload recording menu. Select the recorded file, click Upload, then OK, and finally, Save. You can also change the file name. Now, we need to go to the announcement section and introduce our recorded file as an announcement. Description. Assign a name or description to it. Recording. Select the uploaded recorded file. Repeat. Choose how many times this announcement will be repeated. Allow skip. If this option is checked, the announcement can be skipped. Destination after playback. What happens after the announcement is played? For example, connecting to another IVR, connecting to another announcement, connecting to a specific extension, or ending the call. Be sure to click Submit Changes and then Apply Changes. To create an IVR, go to the IVR menu and click on Add New IVR. IVR Name. Select a desired name for the IVR. IVR Description. Enter sufficient details for future reference. Announcement. Select the announcement created in the previous section. Direct Dial. If you set it to extensions, the recipient can dial the desired extension directly while the IVR is playing. Timeout. Choose the number of seconds the user can select an option after the IVR is played. Invalid Retries. Select the number of incorrect choices the user can make, beyond which the call will be redirected according to the defined list in IVR or extensions. Invalid Destination. Specify what the recipient will be directed to after exhausting the maximum number of incorrect choices, such as connecting to another IVR, connecting to another announcement, connecting to a specific extension, or ending the call. Timeout Retries. Choose the number of retries in case of a timeout. Timeout Destination. Specify what the recipient will be directed to after a timeout, such as connecting to another IVR, connecting to another announcement, connecting to a specific extension, or ending the call. IVR Entries. For example, in IVR, it is announced that if you press 1, you will be connected to extension 213, 2 for another extension, 3 for another IVR, and so on. This section is configurable. We can specify a destination by entering each button. Be sure to click Submit Changes and Apply Changes. Now we need to introduce the IVR in the inbound route. We go to inbound routes and, for example, if the company number is 9999, we enter 9999 in the DID number section. In the Set Destination section, we select the IVR option and then choose the name of our desired IVR. Be sure to click Submit Changes and Apply Changes. To support me, please don't forget like and subscribe.